Okay, let's...
No, well, what? Why?
Why don't you go in there, take a shower, and I'll join you.
No, come on now, babe, come on, let's just get it on, come
Why
on.
Why are you rushing?
Why am I in a rush?
Hey, I'm your wife, and
I want you so much, alright?
Well, I can't blame you. I'm here to stay forever, so
can you just take off your clothes, baby?
I will. Why don't I take these off?
Yeah.
Join you in the bathroom while you get some hot, steaming water.
Oh, come on, I don't do that to me, huh? You know, I'm really turned on right now. You know what water does to the engine room, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, so go in there and I'll join you, okay?
What?
Come on, Fred.
Are you sure?
I am sure. Wouldn't you like for me to give you a hot bath?
What?
Scrub your back? And scrub your rub-a-dub-dub?
You know how I get every time you say that, right? Okay, okay.
How long will it take, baby?
Scrub your back.
How long will it take? How long will it take?
Just a minute. I'm just
going
to pull this off.
You're sure?
Very sure.
You're sure? Alright, I'll be waiting for you. Okay?
Woo! Yum, yum, yummy! I am so lucky. Honey?
Yes, babe?
Is the water hot yet?
Well, yeah. Waiting for you, babe.
Okay, I'm coming.
I'll
make sure you scrub those tubba dubba hubba hubba.
Babe? Sophia.
Sorry, who's Sophia?
My wife. Where's my wife? Huh?
Well, I am Inspector Kelvin from B Division.
Okay.
We got a distress call from this address that someone was screaming for help.
What? Screaming? What are you talking about?
That question should be mine. What's going on here?
I don't know! Alright? I don't know! I have no idea, Inspector! I don't know! You know what, but thank God you're here, alright, because my wife is missing, alright? I don't know, you know, I was just going to call, pick up the...
Clearly.
Yes.
With all this blood on the table.
No. It's not what you think, alright? I was in the bathroom, having my bath, and I was chit-chatting with my wife. Suddenly, I couldn't get a feedback from her, so I came out, looked for her in the bedroom. I couldn't find her, only for me to run down the stairs.
This listen.
My house. All right, look, you have to believe me, officer.
You have to follow me down to the station.
What?
Yes.
My wife is missing, officer. My wife is missing. Help me find my wife. You gotta help me.
Not until you follow me down to the station, because you have some explaining to do.
Officer, I need your help. My wife is missing, and I have blood in my house. I don't know what is going on.
You are wasting my time, Mr. Man.
Can I at least wear something? Can I get into something decent?
Okay, but I have to go with you.
What? All I told you is what happened. Alright? I didn't have my wife. How is that even possible? We just got married and right now I shouldn't be sitting down here.
You are here because your wife is nowhere to be found.
But if you keep me here and keep asking the same question over and over again, how are we going to get to the end of it?
I am doing my job.
Yes, Officer John. Where? Okay, keep her there. I'll be there in a minute. All right, thank you.
My wife? Did they find... Where is she? Where is she? Did they find my wife?
Your mother-in-law is here. Did you call her?
Well, yes, I called her. I mean, she's my mother-in-law. She's my wife's mother. I tried to call everyone that could help. You never can tell. She could help us with leads that could find my wife.
Can you please, can I see her? Please.
Listen, you have to comport yourself here, okay?
How am I supposed to do that, officer? My daughter is nowhere to be found. And this one is sitting down here, rolling his eyes around like the criminal he is. You expect me to be calm?
Well, why are you so dead like this?
Madam, please calm down, okay? Looks like there's something you want to tell us.
Where will I start from? This monster here married my daughter only to kill her and enjoy her money and investment with another idiot that's already pregnant for him.
Pregnant? Sorry, madam. Who's pregnant?
Ask him. Tell him!
No. You tell us. Tell us what your daughter told you, so we can know where to start looking for your daughter.
10 days to my daughter's wedding, she discovered that her so-called best friend planning the wedding with her was already pregnant for the shameless he-goat husband. Oh, Sophie, I warned you. I warned you not to marry this useless man. I warned you not to marry this man, Sophia. I warned you.
Hey, look, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry for barging in on you this way. I know it's not proper. But look at you. Come on. You are a gorgeous woman. And I couldn't just help but, you know, make your acquaintance. My name is Fred, and I'd like to be your friend.
Sorry. Is there any problem?
No, there's no problem at all. I live in this town. I don't know if you live here.
Do I know you?
Not exactly. I am sure that if I had met you before, we would have been friends before now, because you're like the proverbial golden fish. You stand out amongst all. I'm into events, management, and I meet a lot of people from time to time.
Do you know every woman in this town, Mr. Fred?
Not exactly, but I'd like to know you.
Well, my name is Sophia, and when I have any events, I'll let you know.
You never know. You just might need my services someday, but you don't mind me asking. What do you do?
I'm into telemarketing. I have a very hectic work schedule, and I hardly, and I mean hardly, socialize.
Come on, I know you unwind sometimes. I'd like to see you again. Please, come on.
I don't know.
If you give me your number, I could work around your time schedule, trust me. Please.
I'll give you my business card. For any terms of business, you can contact me.
I will call you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
promoted again?
Every day is not my birthday, Mom. It's not a matter of promotion.
Okay.
It's about my future.
Your future? You want to invest your money again?
Is my life all about work and money, Mommy?
Then what?
Mom, I am in love. I'm engaged!
Oh my goodness! God, I'm so happy for you! Oh my God! But baby, the last time we spoke about this, you said you weren't ready yet. And suddenly this?
I know, but life happened. And I was swept off my feet. Now you know I don't easily get swept off my feet by any man. But Fred is just, he's so amazing. He's perfect. He's ambitious. I know it's just a month, Mom, but he's the perfect man for me.
My dear, don't you think this period is too short for you to know all these things about him? Even to accept his proposal? Have you met his parents? Do you know where he comes from, where he works, what he, I mean, I mean, attitude?
Mom, what? I am going to tell you everything. You're the one that have been praying for me to meet a man. And I finally did. Please be happy for me now, Biko.
Okay, you know I'm happy for you, my dear. Your happiness is my happiness, you know that.
I know.
But I just want you to do the right.
Mom, sure I need your right support, man? Yes. Okay. Just support me.
Well, so when am I going to meet this man?
Mom, you're gonna meet him next week, okay? Next weekend. He's amazing. You're gonna love him.
Really?
Yes, you will. You
set it about
it? We are gonna love him.
Okay. I can't wait.
Please, I'm hungry. What's in the house?
Let's go.
Oh, you startled me.
I wish I could do worse to a useless player like you.
Okay, Clara. What do you want?
I want you to cancel that rubbish engagement with Sophia.
Really? And why would I do that?
Because it's supposed to be me.
You're joking now, right? What's wrong with you? Huh? You and I know that marriage was never part of the bargain. What's wrong with you? You know that, right?
Really?
Yeah.
So what was?
Oh, we're having fun. You enjoyed me, I enjoyed you. We're having fun. We had a good time.
The same fun you distribute to every girl in town?
You see, that's your problem. You see, this is the reason I would never marry you. You're petty, you're small-minded, and you have a low mentality. You see, that's your problem.
And you are a useless and shameless womanizer.
I'm a womanizer. Yet I have found myself a woman who is way above your league. What, do you think you're anything to be compared to my Sophie? Come on, man. Please, leave me be.
Well, we'll see how long this your new passion will last. And honey, I will have the last laugh.
Did you just threaten me?
Fred, I will deal with you. I will deal with you, Fred. Mark my words, I will deal with you. Oh my goodness, I am so disappointed. And that even you! So there are no men left in this town, you have to go sleeping with Fred.
Clara. You should be very disappointed at yourself. Yes. You put me into this stupid situation and here you are talking.
Wait, oh. No. She put you into the situation, ha!
Hey, Jibo. Clara here has been sleeping with Fred too.
What?
Yes. Long before Fred met Sophia.
You're a liar, Dad. You're a liar. Keep quiet.
Clara, why should I lie? I saw you both at Nancy's wedding. Fred had you in the toilet. I recorded your steaming session with him.
Oh, really? So you've been blackmailing him into sleeping with you? Shameless thing.
Clara, you have no moral rights to judge me. We're in the same boat, sweetheart.
Darling, we are not in the same boat. I give him jobs. There's a difference. What do you offer him?
Nothing!
I am not Clara, nothing. You give him nothing.
Don't!
What do you
Clara,
offer him?
You don't!
What do you
nothing. You give him
you
nothing.
You offer him nothing, my darling. You don't give him anything. Fucking bitch.
God! What is wrong with the two of you? Aren't you girls ashamed of yourselves? God! Can you listen to the things and words oozing out of your mouth? My goodness! I can't even bring myself to tell Sophia any of these ugly tales. It's just gonna break her into shreds. Now listen to me, both of you. Fred has made his choice. And there is nothing any of you can do about it. If you like, you can kill yourself. The gentleman is not gonna do anything about it. What is this? You girls are so despicable. God, I'm still gonna pay that guy a visit. I will want him to respect himself and our friend.
Ada, I am warning you, stay away from my lane. Stay out of my lane because I will crush you. I am not joking, I will crush
Clara,
you.
Clara, you have
no lane. You
can't tell me that.
You don't
know you
have
to
be
that.
Just mind your teeth. See, one half. It is because of you I'm taking this walk.
Clara, you don't get lane. You don't get level. You don't be stopping me.
Would you get stop me?
Stop this. What nonsense is this? I'm still going to pay that guy a visit. Let this rubbish stop.
Mom, what's going on?
I don't like the kind of dreams I have these days. Are you fighting or quarreling with anybody?
Fighting? I'm not fighting with anyone. I'm too busy prepping for my wedding, talk less of having time to fight with anyone, Mom.
You don't have any problems with Fred?
No, not at all. That one that pampers me like a small egg.
3 days ago, I dreamt about what happened between you and your brother many years ago. The day you broke his head.
Come on, Mom. Can you not bring that up? That was like how many years ago? I was young and naive. And you of all people should know that I do not look for trouble anywhere. You should know that. And you remember I've gotten special help and counseling, Mom. I can't remember the last time I had an argument, talk less of fighting with someone.
You're right, my dear. You've really grown beyond my imagination. But you still need to be careful. This is trying period. Please, whatever comes your way, just take it calmly. So that the devil will have no room to strike, okay?
Amen, no, amen. I've heard you. Amen. I will make sure I stay away from any problems, from anyone.
Mm-hmm. Mom, remember what you promised me, that you'll come to my house a week before the wedding.
Yeah, we still have 3 weeks and I'm putting my things together.
Okay. I might fight you if you don't.
And how is Fred?
Fred is fine. We've just been so busy putting the weddings together.
Hello?
Where are you?
Yeah, Ichiro.
Yes, I need to see you.
Well, is everything okay?
Everything is fine. I just need to see you. It's actually for your own good.
Okay, but I'm currently at an event at Aja. That's a bit far from where you are, but I'm in my hotel room resting at the moment. I don't know if you can make it this far.
All right, tell me where you are and send me the address and I will be there.
Okay, I'll do so.
Very good. All right.
Any idea that Ada and Clara are very angry at you right now? They are so willing to spoil things for you out of jealousy.
I know, I'm aware. I know how bitter those women are because, you know, both of them have threatened me at a different occasion, so I believe you.
Seriously, you don't understand. The both of them have been at each other's neck. They have every right to do so. Come on. I'm a woman, I know how it feels to be jilted for your friend. It feels like you're not woman enough to keep a man down and all that. It's very frustrating.
I know, but she was blackmailing me.
Fred, you have no excuse. You led them on. You are a willing accomplice, so don't even go there.
I know. And for what it's worth, I'm really sorry. You know, I didn't mean for the whole thing to blow up this way and look this dirty. Okay? I understand I'm a man and I should be in control of my actions and myself most of the time. But you know, sometimes I don't know what happens to me. You know, I just let my feelings get ahead of me and I do things that I am ashamed of. I'm sorry.
Well, I talked to both of them. And we came to an agreement. They both agreed to move on with their life and forget about the past. And they also promised that they are going to support Sophia wholeheartedly.
Really?
But that is because I went out of my way to convince them to just keep quiet about the whole thing.
Ah, oh, thank you. Because I don't know how to thank. Thank you so much. You know, because I've been wondering, you know, how do we put this whole fiasco to an end so that I can move on with my life, you know.
You're welcome. But you have to avoid any form of confrontation with them. Those girls can be very dangerous.
I know.
Seriously, you don't know how far they can go. They have nothing to lose, but you do. So you have to be careful. Stop bragging about Sophia in their presence. Stop mocking them. Just do your thing and move on with your life. It's that simple. Stop making it look like it's a whole big thing.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I should please not bother you. You deserve it.
No way. Oh. Yeah, I'm okay. I don't need anything.
You deserve it.
I don't need anything. I'm fine. Nah. I just came to just settle this with you.
Nah.
No, stop. Okay. Bye.
Yeah, is that the bar? Yeah. Please, I would like
whiskey.
Yeah, for two.
No, you did not.
You are not serious.
No, you did not. How can you describe me like that? No, you did. Now that's the last for the night. All right, that's the last for the night. You have to go. I know I'll call you a cab, though. I'll call you a cab and you go, alright? And you have to go.
I will go.
Why do you want to go? Do you know what time it is?
I don't care.
Come on.
See, I'm old enough to take care of myself. No, this is Lagos. I can go anytime.
Look, let's get you a cab so you can go.
No.
What? You have to go. What's wrong with you now?
I'll go.
What are you doing? Nothing. What do you mean nothing? What are you doing?
I'm not doing anything.
Oh, come on, stop now. Stop. Don't do this.
Don't do this.
No, I'm not doing it.
But you're doing something. You're running your hands through, you know.
So we have sold 30 assuring pieces already. So this is like the last two. And
it's very beautiful.
Okay.
It's very fun, yes.
It's exactly how I wanted it. So it's gonna come down and when he wants to come.
It's perfect. It's gonna fit you very well. It's gonna be very funny.
Oh, you want to cry now? No. This is very, very beautiful. And it's going to look so good. Your perfect shape.
I can't believe my dream is coming true.
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
All right.
So, that woman, no, Mama.
The Quechua, yes. Please. Yes, she sets.
I beg. I don't want any problems with the food.
Everything
okay, so we have
okay.
Swallow, we have rice, mm-hmm. we have different protein. Yes. Like goat meat, chicken, beef. Asu, all those kind of stuff.
Everything is okay.
Ijo, so we're good.
The food area, covered.
Then the decor.
The woman, yes. She gave us her word. She's going
to
do
it. You know, I told you I want it to be like Wonderland. I want shiny. I want white and blue. Then I want sparkles. I want design. I want it to have all the sherry stuff. Then I want the whole... Ijo, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. My eyes are turning. I've been feeling kind of dizzy for some days now. I don't know why.
Well,
maybe it's the stress.
Yeah, I understand. You know, the whole wedding stuff.
Yeah,
and
of course.
Everything.
Once we are done with everything, I'm just going to take a whole week and rest.
I know. 2 more weeks, everything will be over, okay?
Very soon. Yeah.
Okay.
Let me use the toilet, please.
Okay. Turn off. Are you sure you're okay, Joe?
I'm fine.
Why are you staggering like that? You're okay.
Yeah, I'm fine. Just
when was the last time you saw a doctor? Maybe you have malaria. Have you checked up for malaria?
Can't really remember, but I'm okay. Just get me a drink. Spirits precisely, please.
You don't want water?
No. Just spirits, please, I'll be fine.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, so I have this drink. Okay, Fred's favorite, so it's not water, you know. It's alcohol.
Oh yeah.
This is my only addiction. Though sometimes it makes me useless. But it's okay, I love it.
Well, the Lord is your strength, my dear.
Thank you.
I'll keep the rest.
Thank you so much.
Okay, so let's get back to the wedding.
Yeah.
Why don't you go in there, take a shower, and I'll join you.
No, come on now, babe. Come on, let's just get it on. Come
Why
on.
Why are you rushing?
Why would I rush?
Hey, I'm your wife,
and I want you so much. All right.
Well, I can't blame you. I'm here to stay forever. So
can you just take off your clothes, baby?
I will. Why don't I take these off?
Yeah.
Join you in the bathroom while you get some hot, steaming water.
Oh, come on, I don't do that to me. Huh? You're not really turned on right now. You know what it does to the engine room, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, so go in there and I'll join you, okay?
What?
Come on, Fred.
Are you sure?
I am sure. You sure? Wouldn't you like for me to give you a hot bath?
What?
Scrub your back? And scrub your rubber dub dub?
You know how I get every time you say that, right? Okay, so, okay.
How long will it take you?
Scrub your back.
How long will it take? How long will it take?
Just a minute. I'm just taking all this off.
You're sure?
Very sure.
You're sure? Alright, I'll be waiting for you. Okay?
Yum, yum, yummy! I am so lucky. Honey?
Yes, babe?
Is the water hot yet?
Well, yeah. Waiting for you, babe.
Okay, I'm coming.
Okay.
Make sure you scrub those tubba-dubba-hubba-hubba.
Babe?
Sophia.
My wife. Where's my wife? Huh?
Well, I am Inspector Kelvin from B Division.
Okay.
We got a distress call from this address that someone was screaming for help.
Whoa. Screaming? What are you talking about?
That question should be mine. What's going on here?
I don't know! Alright? I don't know! I have no idea, Inspector! I don't know! You know what? But thank God you're here, alright? Because my wife is missing! Alright, I don't know, you know, I was just gonna call, pick up the
Clearly.
Yes.
With all this blood on the table.
No, I'm just, no. It's not what you think, alright? I was in the bathroom, having my bath, and I was chit-chatting with my wife. Suddenly I couldn't get a feedback from her, so I came out, look for her in the bedroom. I couldn't find her, only for me to run down the stairs.
Listen.
In my house. Alright, look, you have to believe me, officer.
You have to follow me down to the station.
What?
Yes.
My wife is missing, officer. My wife is missing. Help me find my wife. You gotta help me.
Not until you follow me down to the station, because you have some explaining to do.
Officer. I need your help. My wife is missing. And I have blood in my house. I don't know what is going on.
You are wasting my time, Mr. Man.
At least wear something. Can I get into something decent?
Okay, but I have to go with you.
What? All I told you is what happened. All right. I didn't harm my wife. How is that even possible? We just got married and right now I shouldn't be sitting down here.
You are here because your wife is nowhere to be found.
But if you keep me here and keep asking the same question over and over again, how are we going to get to the end of
I am doing my job. Yes, Officer John. Where? Okay, keep her there. I'll be there in a minute. Alright, thank you.
My wife? Did they find... Where is she? Did they find my wife?
Your mother-in-law is here. Did you call her?
Well, yes, I called her. I mean, she's my mother-in-law. She's my wife's mother. I tried to call everyone that could help. You never can tell. She could help us with leads that could find my wife. Can I see her? Please.
Listen, you have to comport yourself here, okay?
How am I supposed to do that, officer? My daughter is nowhere to be found. And this one is sitting down here, rolling his eyes around like the criminal he is. You expect me to be calm?
Well, why are you so dead like this?
Madam,
please calm down, okay? Looks like there's something you want to tell us.
Where will I start from? This monster here married my daughter only to kill her and enjoy her money and investment with another idiot that's already pregnant for him.
Pregnant? Sorry, ma'am. Who's pregnant?
Ask him. Tell him!
No. You tell us. Tell us what your daughter told you. So we can know where to start looking for your daughter.
10 days to my daughter's wedding, she discovered that her so-called best friend planning the wedding with her was already pregnant for the shameless he-goat husband. Oh, Sophie, I warned you. I warned you not to marry this useless man. I warned you not to marry this man, Sophia. I warned you! Where is my daughter?
Hello? Look, I don't understand what you're saying. You hear me? You have to do it. You just have to do it. What is wrong with you?
I don't care. I do not care. All right? Look, I'm not going to let your stupidity ruin my wedding for me. What's wrong with you now? Huh?
Look, I'm somewhere for an important meeting. Do you understand me? Don't call me again. I will call you when I'm done. Just do it. It was your fault. Just do it.
You too, baby. Don't mind me, I'm just a bit pressed, you know.
Okay.
Alright, just let me ease myself, I'll be back.
Oh, sure.
Okay?
You know where the bathroom is.
Sure.
You can't ruin my own life and live yours happily ever after. No way. I won't take it. I'm doing no abortion. You better call me back or I will shock you. You got me drunk and raped me. And now you blame me. Don't call me back and see what happens to you.
Who is it, Joe?
I said, who is Ajiro?
If you let me explain, if you let me explain to you, I promise you, no. I'll tell you how it happened.
No, Fred, don't tell me it's my friend. No. Don't tell me it's the same Ajiro who is planning our wedding.
She seduced me.
The same, what?
She seduced me. I didn't mean to.
Then my friend, Ajiro,
babe,
you.
Calm down.
You pregnated. You no. pregnated.
You have to go.
I don't. I'll call you a cab, though.
I'll call you a cab,
and you go. All right. But you have to go.
I'll go when I want to go.
Why? Why do you want to go? Do you know what time it is?
I don't care.
Come on, come on, come on.
See, I'm old enough to take care of myself. No, this is Lagos. I can't go anytime.
Look, let's get you a cab so you can go.
No.
What? You have to go. What's wrong with you now? What are you doing? What do you mean nothing? What are you doing?
This is my only addiction, though sometimes it makes me useless. But it's okay, I love it.
Sophia, you know that I love you very well. And I would not want to hurt you on purpose. I swear to God, it wasn't me. It was Ada and Clara. They were the ones sleeping with Red. I went to talk to him to stay away from them. Just you. And I was drunk.
Shut up! I don't want to hear you. You disgust me, Adriel. Now I give you 12 hours to leave this town and never you return. Now if I see you around here in the next 12 hours, I'll kill you.
I don't deserve it. I don't.
I knew there was something wrong somewhere. Those dreams were not for nothing. The first day I saw that man, my spirit told me he was trouble. I looked into his eyes and I saw a harem of girls following him and him following another league of girls. He was too nice, too good, too smooth to be true. Now the wind has blown and we have seen it all. How can a sane man who wants to marry a woman visit her family, did the traditional rites, even fix the date of his wedding, only to go behind and start sleeping with his wife's friends, an even pregnanted one? Is that not madness? An abomination. Hi. But my daughter said she loved him. What sort of stupid love? Oh, Sophia. So much work has made my daughter so naive and weak. Thank God everything is exposed early enough. My daughter would have fallen deep into a shithole of marriage. Hey, Cordelia. What is it, Jay? Hi. Oh, what do I tell my friends? All the preparations? Invitation cards shared? As should I be? Etc, etc. Hi. What do I tell them? That my son-in-law turned out to be a useless he-goat, embarrassing himself around the neighborhood. Hi. Cordelia, this is not the life you planned for your daughter. No. Oh God of Isaac, Abraham and Jacob, where have I gone wrong?
Okay. Mom, you didn't do anything wrong. And nothing has changed yet. The wedding is still going to take place.
What?
You heard me right. I am going to marry Fred come next Saturday.
No, you won't marry him. Unless you want to kill me and also kill yourself. This boy has no good plans for you, Sophia. He just wants your money so he can maintain the harem of his girls.
So what do you want me to do? What? I can't go back now, can I? I am going to marry that man.
Someone is pregnant for him.
So what? She's already out of the picture. She has left town and never to return.
Oh God, help me. Help me, I don't know my daughter anymore.
Mom, can't you see that they're all envious? They're all a bunch of jealous friends. They went after Fred. But he chose me. I am going to stand by that man.
Stand by a womanizer? A Casanova?
So what do you want me to do? What? Go after another man? Whom I don't know if he's worse than Fred? Besides the girl's distraction, Fred is the perfect man for me. He has a beautiful soul. And I love him.
Oh my God. God help me. I knew it would not end well. Tell this animal to produce my daughter else!
Madam, it's okay. It's okay. We will get to the root of this. Please kindly wait at the reception.
Mr. Womanizer. You need to get your lawyer. Because this is a murder investigation.
Offense, Inspector.
No, this is a homicide case. Your client is the prime suspect. He had the motive.
And what's that?
A pregnant woman elsewhere. He needs to be with her.
Oh, come on, Inspector. This is a hearsay. Where is the woman?
That is what the investigation will uncover. And that is why bail must be denied.
No, Inspector. You see, look, for a case to be qualified as a murder case, the evidence have to be explicit. Without the body of a supposed victim, this is just a missing case. You can't just come up from nowhere and call it a murder case. Look, you should be thinking of who else wants to harm the wife, not pinning it on my client who is just a victim here. So I put it to you that this is a case of a missing person. Until there's an evidence proving contrary. You know the law. We should be discussing this.
We shall see to that.
Then I'm waiting.
You know, somehow I still feel very funny about what happened, and I don't know, I just feel guilty every time I'm around you still. And I just want to take this time to say that I'm sorry. Okay? I'm really sorry.
It's okay. And I have told you to stop apologizing since that day. I already forgive you. And my friends. So can we just let go and focus on our wedding, please?
You know you have the heart of an angel, right?
Well, you can say that again. I know.
And I just love you. Yes, babe.
And I love you more.
Thank you.
Mama, you have been released.
Oh, really?
You can go home. For now, though.
Okay.
Kanto, I hope you know that this man must not live down.
Oh, but yeah.
He has to make himself available for questioning and investigation.
Oh, yeah, sure. Every time you need him, just call me and I'll make him available.
Good.
Officer, one of the handcuffs.
I'll send one of my officers to come get it.
Alright. Well, thank you so much. Thank you. You have a count. Thank you so much.
It's okay. He'll be staying at my place.
Why? What are you talking about? What about my clothes? What about my shoes? How about my car? Huh?
Fred.
Yes.
Look, you will stay at my place. Your house has been sealed off by the police. It's a crime scene. Look, you can't go there now until the police say so.
Honestly, I didn't hear. It was Bimbo who called me this morning and narrated the whole saga to me. I was absolutely speechless.
You don't know how I feel, man. You don't have the slightest idea. My head is filled with random thoughts. Where could my wife be? You know? Who would want to hurt Sophia? Who?
Well, you see, if not for the bloodstains, I would have said she walked out on you.
Nah, Sophia. Nah. She wanted to be married. She was excited about the marriage, just like I am, you know. She wanted to be married. No, she wouldn't have left me.
What of this lady, Clara and Ada? Have you heard from them?
No, I haven't. Why?
Because this whole scenario seems to me like a woman's retaliation.
You could be right. I mean, given the fact that these two women at one point threatened me at the same time, you could be right. But look, Steve, I don't want to get them involved in this.
And why?
Look, these are women, Steve. These are women, all right? You bring them into the picture, you know, they begin to dig up old coals, and then they complicate matters for me now. I just want to concentrate on finding my wife.
I understand you're trying to run away from a nemesis. I do. Just leave everything to me and Manuel. We'll sort things out.
If you insist, but I still think that these two women are incapable of doing what you're insinuating, man. I don't think so.
What? Like, hey, you should never underestimate the power of any woman, no matter how small you think she is. Never. So, can I have their numbers?
Yeah, I'll. It's okay. I'll give it to you. Once we get in, I'll give it to you. Is that a problem?
Steve. Hey.
Hello, Manuel. The other thing, Manuel, I never heard of anything that happened. I needed to give them time, thinking they were enjoying their honeymoon. And all this happened.
My brother, you know, this is life. You can expect anything at any time.
Yeah, thank God you will stay around.
I am doing my best for him not to be indicted.
Yeah, that's true. I love the spirit. Bro, I just calm down. Everything will be under control. Just leave everything to me and Manuel. Okay? Just leave everything to us. Both of us can be here and then. What you think? It's not possible. Yeah.
Do it! I didn't do anything to Sophia, she's my friend.
Look, you're a blackmailer. You threatened to expose your relationship with Fred to Sophia. But when Fred called your bluff, you killed Sophia. Two of us!
No, they didn't do anything. They did not.
Just tell us who you planned this evil act with.
I did not plan anything with anybody, I swear, I did not. I did not. My God. What kind of problem is this?
Whoa. It's the kind of problem blackmailers get themselves involved in.
Sergeant.
Hello, listen.
My problem is this girl. My daughter.
Chair. What happened, sir?
I keep asking myself, what kind of brain is inside the head of this my daughter? That she will reject all the men that are trooping in and out of my house every day. This one will come and go. This one will come and go. She will reject all of them and be running around a married man. A killer married man. Ask her! Since that man killed his wife, Has he married her? Answer me.
Daddy, did you come here to bail me or to embarrass me? Which one have you come to do? What's the meaning of this now?
Are you listening to her? So telling you the truth now is embarrassment. That's what your mother taught you, eh? Telling you the truth is embarrassment. My brother, this is what I have suffered. Like mother, like daughter.
Daddy, if you have come here to wash your family's dirty clothes in public, that is fine. But do not implicate my mother. Just leave her out of it. Because at the end of the day, you failed. Point blank, period.
Did you hear that? Hi. My daughter is calling me a failure.
Okay, now listen to the sequel.
Ah, you have not seen anything.
Which one gave you this?
Look at this man, no.
You call me this man.
What's wrong with you, sir?
It's okay.
Call me this man.
Come and touch me.
No, you shut up your mouth there.
Pardon, I'm dating manners.
Come. You don't say you don't say your papa gets a hot temper.
Wait. First of all those your useless drunk friends, are they the ones you're calling suitors? They are the ones you want me to marry, Abi.
Come on. Did you? You can see my life.
Child.
This is like mother, like daughter.
Child.
Whatever you see in this girl, that is the mother for you. That woman devastated my life. I was doing well in civil service. I'm a qualified engineer.
Yeah?
Yes! Grade level 12.
Yeah.
Family crisis forced me to retire.
Child.
Ignominiously. No retirement benefit. No pension.
Hmm?
Nothing.
Just like that.
Look at me.
Hey!
Everything you see me put on now and trying to manage my life is things I have.
I get them before.
You are not ashamed of yourself.
Which one gave you this?
You have not seen anything. They don't give me food.
Eh?
I cook my own food.
She don't give me
food. Ask her.
Chai.
Ask her.
Lady, in the kitchen.
Oh. You have not seen suffering. So you are defending your mother, eh? You came here to defend your mother.
Okay, go and beg.
Okay, go and call your mother to bail you.
Hey, okay.
Let's go and call her mother to bail her.
You never reach like that.
No thanks for waiting. Did I call you? Answer me, did I call you? Go and beg. Okay, give me my phone. Let me call someone.
Come. No, enough. If you talk pain now, I'll take you back to that. What did they worry you?
You have not seen anything, though.
Your papa leave once. Make you come see
how you want.
Now you're there, the white man.
Go and move, please. Let me call somebody else. Come and bring me.
Who is now?
Go!
All these Yahoo boys, all of them. Yahoo, everywhere in my house. Yahoo. Look at her.
So tell the girl Yahoo has called. Come on.
What is it? Her mates are getting married. And she's just never Yahoo boys. And now she's insulting me. It's okay. We will see in the house.
Your papa don't go.
We will see in the house.
Okay, back for her, then go.
Your papa don't go.
Give me my phone.
I don't want. Oh, this is a bad man. Shut up! I don't talk to you. I will slap the living daylight out of your score. Call carry phone. Call carry phone.
Mike, I just wish you're here. I need you now. I'm not myself. Yeah, the police are still on it. That Fred, he said he doesn't know anything about it, that he doesn't know her whereabouts. But I know he's lying. I know Fred has a hand in this. Oh, and this is the time I need you most. I just wish you're here. I'm losing it, Mike. How can I calm down? I don't know where your sister is. You're telling me to calm down. Aren't you worried there? Okay, fine. I'll take my drugs. Okay, but when will you be through with your training? I need you here. Your mom can't do this alone. Mike, I'm losing it. Please. Okay. All right. No problem.
You know, it's still not clear to me how the police got to the scene at that time. And you said you didn't make any call. And you didn't hear anyone scream.
No, I did not.
said you were singing?
Oh yes, I was singing.
So were you singing that loud that you could not hear anyone scream?
Steve, I wouldn't know. You know, it's all so confusing now. What's up? What are you thinking?
Nothing really. I'm very sure something is not sitting right. But I'm sure we'll crack this puzzle if we get to know exactly how the police got to the scene at that time.
Yeah, well, makes a lot of sense to me. I think so too.
So, this Kevin of a guy, have you met him before now?
No, I hadn't seen him before. That was the first time I was seeing him.
It's okay. I'm sure the nickel will drop soon.
Excuse me.
Madam.
I want to see the person in charge of the case of that woman they killed after her wedding.
Oh, you mean the woman that got missing a night after her wedding?
Missing? Not be missing, they killed her. Missing care. In fact, I want to see the person in charge. Who is in charge of the case?
Okay, that should be Inspector Kevin. But he went out though.
Well, I don't know. But I have an important information to give.
About the woman or the man?
The woman they killed. They killed.
Okay, sit down for charge room. Wait on Kevin. Okay. In the car.
Okay. I hope the Kevin is coming back. Because the information is very, very important too.
Sit down for charge room.
At a seat.
Madam, say your name is...
My name is Jane and I used to be Sophia's friend in Egweda. Few days to her wedding, we met and she told me a whole lot of things. You know, as a Christian that I am, very good Christian, when I heard what happened to her, I decided to come and tell the police what I know.
It's okay, madam. At this stage, every information, it's important. Okay, so just go ahead and tell us.
Well, she told me her husband was cheating on her with her friends. He even stole her money. And when she complained, he would beat her blue, black, and red like a punching bag.
Hold on. You mean the husband beats her blue, black, and red?
Exactly! Yes. And when I asked her why she's still going into the marriage, she said that she had no choice. But the way she even said it, that she loved him desperately, that she hated the way she loved him.
Okay. Do you know this man? I mean, the husband.
Yes, I know him very well. One tall, fair, handsome young man. Then looking at him, he appears gentle. You even think he's an angel, but inside of him, he's a devil.
But madam, we are not here to judge characters. Okay, so just state the facts, then we'll make our judgments, okay?
Well, I've said it all, but she told me he planned to kill her.
What?
Yes.
Can you say this again? Like, repeat what you said. Just repeat it again.
She told me he planned to kill her.
How?
Because he impregnated one of her friends. And I actually wanted to marry her. I'm sure by now, she will be waiting for him somewhere, now that my friend is gone.
Madam, can you say these things in his presence?
Of course. Any day, any time. Just for the sake of the wife. Oh. Such a nice and wonderful woman.
Well, thank you, Madam Jane, for this wonderful information.
Thank you.
Okay, with people like you, I mean, this country will be a great and a crime-free country. Right, so just wait for us outside. I'll come and get your statement.
Thank you.
Alright. You heard it all. You've heard it from a good citizen of this great country. So now that the jigsaw puzzle is solved, I want you to come with Fred to the station for fresh questioning and clarification of this testimony.
Don't tell me you believe that crap.
I am the investigating officer in charge of this case, not you. So bring your client to the station.
I maintain that this testimony is false.
This is our best lead until proven otherwise, okay?
Inspector, this is trash until it's proven true!
Counsel, bring Fred your client to the station or I will order for his rearrest. Am I making myself clear?
What is going on? What is happening to me, God? Whatever sin I must have committed, Lord, please forgive me. Ah, save me from this torture. What is happening? Ah. Something is seriously wrong somewhere. Where could she be? Lord, please let nothing happen to my wife if she's kidnapped. If she's kidnapped, the kidnappers would have called by now. What is going on? Huh? What is happening? God, please help me. Help me find my wife.
Who's this?
You don't know me.
I know you.
But I know you. And I know where you can find your missing wife.
What? You know where I can find my wife?
Yes.
Alright, who are you? Who are
you? It's better you don't know.
Look, are you joking with me or you're trying to mock me?
You can believe anything.
Okay, so how am I sure that this is not a joke?
Diary. Sophia's diary. It contains some informations. Useful informations that will convince you I am not joking.
Look, I can't go to my house. It's been barricaded by the police. It's a crime scene.
No one will know you went there. Except you told them. If you really want to find your wife, you must go now.
Hello?
Fred proposed to me with the most beautiful engagement ring in the whole world. He knelt and said, "Sophia, will you marry me?" And I said, "Yes. Thank you, Lord." I am sad and heartbroken. Today being the 15th day of July is my worst day. I found out my best friend was pregnant for my fiancé and my two other best friends had been sleeping with him behind my back. And my wedding is just weeks away. God, let me wake up from this dream. My best friend Ajiro leaves town today, 30th of July, so that our secret can be safe.
Hello? Hey, you! I see nothing here. These are just dates. Nothing. Where's my wife? Where is she?
Go to number 5, Newman Street, off housing estate. You will get the answer you need right now.
Hello? Hello?
This case seems like a dead end.
Let's not give up yet, okay?
Inspector Lida is very right. I mean, can't you see it?
We have to be optimistic, okay? We have to keep doing our best.
Like we've been sleeping all day.
Listen, Linda, listen. I know you both are exhausted. I am too, okay? But what if this woman is alive somewhere? Think!
But why haven't the kidnappers called yet? Yes, why?
Exactly.
Okay. What if the kidnappers want to punish the man or the woman? I mean, from all we've gathered so far, this man is a chronic womanizer. Okay? So when I say something... Sorry. Yeah, hello? Okay. Where? Alright, just hold on. We'll be there. Thank you. We have an emergency.
Okay.
The woman that is fighting against Fred.
Yes. Okay, so.
I just walked in here and I saw her.
Shut up!
I didn't do it.
You killed her because she testified against you.
That's not true. I did not do it. I'm innocent.
Shut up!
I didn't do it.
Move this man. Move it!
It's not true.
Move it!
Heat is on. By now he would be answering police questions. He needs to learn a lesson or two about being responsible and being with one woman. Yes. Oh, I've worked so hard for myself and I deserve the best. I do. I deserve a peaceful marriage where my husband will adore and respect me. Not one to share with every girl or every concubines out there in town. I trust Kelvin would do the job. Wait, but I hope he won't hurt him more. No, he won't. We had an agreement, and I paid him well. In a few days, it will all be over. I will come out released by some fake kidnappers. Fred will be overjoyed to see me back. I will give him conditions to stay in the marriage. Yes, I will. I will keep reminding him of this to keep him in check. Whew, I cannot believe I pulled this off. It's better than fighting and breaking somebody's head, isn't it? Oh no, my mom. Poor, sweet mother of mine. She must be having more dreams than nightmares by now. But this is also for her own good. Is it not better I'm settled and happy? If so, she will also be happy.
Demetri, what's going on?
Shh. Just cooperate with me, okay? Listen, I am in charge here now, okay? So just cooperate with me, alright?
What are you talking about?
Listen, just cooperate with me, okay? And I will help you do something, alright?
What are you going to do for me?
I will reveal the plan to you, okay? Just...
plan? What plan are you talking about?
Listen. Okay, fine. If you want to know, it's the next move for my man. Okay? Are you confused here? Listen, just relax, okay? Just cooperate with me and I'll tell you.
What? Okay, tell me the plan first.
Okay. Listen, you need to cooperate with me now, okay? I mean, I'll tell you of the plan when we're done. But for now, just cooperate with me, okay? And I'll tell you everything you need to know, okay?
Tell me the plan first!
Why are you trying to be hard? Come with me!
What's going on? What have you done?
I should be asking you that question. What have you done? You sent this animal to come and rape me.
Rape you? No! I only wanted him to help us.
Help us what? And why did you change our plan?
Listen, baby. I didn't change our plans, okay? Unforeseen things are happening, and I'm just adjusting to it.
No, you listen. I only contracted you just to shake my husband up a little so that he would stay away from those sexual escapades and so that I can have a good marriage. I only wanted you to make it seem like I was kidnapped by someone out there. That's the reason why we made that fake video in the first place. But no, look at what you're doing now. You're changing our plan.
Sophia, baby, you know you're a very funny girl. So you think I am going to waste my time?
my talent to work for another man to live with you happily ever after. While I live without you sorrowfully ever after. I mean, that's not possible. I am supposed to be your first love here. But what did you do? You turned me down!
What?
You never gave me the chance to prove to you how much I love you! Now the chance fell on my laps. You want me to throw it away? Never! I won't.
What are you talking about?
Listen, baby. Fred, it's going in for life imprisonment or death sentence for the murder of Jane.
What? Wait. Who's Jane?
Never mind. She's just a stalker. Now listen, baby. I have all the evidence wrapped up. And after that, we're going to court. And after court, you and I will live happily ever after.
You're a psycho, Kelvin. You are crazy.
Baby. Remember, I was the Capone back then in school. I am still that bad guy you used to know. Don't joke with me.
Oh my goodness. So you mean you're out to destroy my marriage?
You're the Kevin! You just wanted to get married to
no.
him!
No!
You're punishing for all the pain it cost you!
No! No, I do! It's a lie! I love my husband! I love my husband!
No! It is me that you must love now!
No! I can never love you, Kelvin. I can't love you. You disgust me.
You? You dare say that to my face? You dare say that to my face, Sophia!
I am not afraid of you, Kelvin. How can you be so treacherous?
Baby, listen. I am the IP hero of this case. And I can twist it to the direction that I want. Okay? You can be the accomplice to the murder of Jane. Get that into your head. Okay? Get that into your head.
No. You don't know what you're saying. I recorded our discussion from the beginning. Yes, I did.
You what? Baby. You recorded our discussions.
Yes, I did.
Huh. Okay. Okay. In that case, you will remain missing. Goodbye, love.
Hold it there!
It's all right. It's okay. It's okay. Are you okay? Are you all right? What happened? Huh?
It's a long story, but thank God it's all over.
Okay, fine. I want to know what happened. Where did you find her? Huh?
Your wife was kidnapped.
What?
Kidnapped? Huh?
Wait, what?
Are you okay? Are you sure? It's okay. You know what? Let's just go in.
Is the water hot yet?
Well, yeah, waiting for you, babe.
Okay, I'm coming.
Okay.
Make sure you scrub those tubba dubba hubba hubba.
Okay, babe.
Are you okay? Hello?
My name is Timo. I work for Oga Kelvin.
What? Why, what's going on?
I don't know anything, madam. But he called me and said I should take you out of here immediately because the police will be here anytime.
What's going on?
He didn't tell me. He just said if I told you this, you would understand. Hurry, please, madam.
Hello? Hello? From then on, I didn't see Kelvin again until that last night. I was confused. I didn't know what to do, Mom. I didn't. And all I could do was just pray and waited, and I knew something had gone wrong with our initial plan.
And who was Kelvin to you, if I may ask?
Kelvin was just my classmate. He was a notorious cult guy from the university. I ran into him some time ago and we exchanged numbers, and when this idea came to my mind, I contacted him. That was it. Nothing more. Nothing more, please, I'm sorry. Fred, you know I love you and I would never do anything to hurt you. It wasn't supposed to turn out like this. I'm sorry. Please.
You know you're wicked? Do you know you're wicked?
Don't say that.
How could you? How could you make me go through all that?
I love you.
And you deal here, you shut up! And you deal here and tell me that you love me? You love me. Love me how? Well, I go through all of this and then you and I are supposed to live under the same roof as man and wife. How?
I'm sorry.
It's not possible.
It wasn't supposed to be like this. Mom, it wasn't supposed to be like this. Please, Mom.
I was still trying to recover from his madness. And you started yours, Sophia. What if they had killed you?
No.
You didn't even think of me and your brother? Who even told you that's the way to change a man? Who told you that?
The Mom. Both of you are just two mad people.
Mom, please, I'm begging you.
Settle your case by yourself.
Mom, beg you for me. Mom, please. Fred, please, I'm sorry, please. Please, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to. Please, I'm sorry. It wasn't supposed to be like this. You should know that I love you, but I'll never hurt you, please. It wasn't supposed to turn out like this. I'm sorry.